Good morning. I'm here with Marc Langevin, the General Manager of the Ritz-Carlton Grand Cayman. Marc, good morning. How are you?
Good morning. Here we are again. A few weeks has passed since we last talked, and it's certainly a continuously changing environment, isn't it?
Yeah, every time we talk, something new is happening, something changes. Last night you opened the restaurants for the first time. Is this a small step towards normalcy resuming at the hotel?
Yes, it is. It is a small step, but a big step at the same time. A small step because clearly it's not going to lead us to success financially, but from the point of view of bringing back people to work, that was essential.
And is that going to continue? Are you able to do it with the reduced number of diners?
Let's just say that the way we operate today, it's a first step. It's establishing new protocol, but it's certainly not sustainable. So for the time being, it is what it is, and we are going to learn. But I'm certainly hopeful that people will understand in the government and in the whole health industry that we're going to need to evolve and potentially take some calculated risk to allow to operate in a different manner. It's just not sustainable for long term.
And does that apply for bringing tourists back here as well? I mean, this is a hotel after all. At some point, you're going to need guests.
You cannot operate a hotel with what we are doing today. Imagine in a restaurant, usually we do 100, 200 covers, and right now we only make 30 covers. So that means that we could only open the restaurant for 20 rooms. It's not possible. So I think today is just relaunching, bringing back people to work, relearning, and how to do business. Some of the things we do will stay, especially in anything to do with sanitation, even social distancing at a certain point, but a lot of the measures will have to change to be able to go back to a respectable level of business. There is no question about it.
Are you confident that we will see tourists back in this hotel this year?
Wow. We will see tourism, we will see a guest back in the hotel. But at what levels? It's obviously something that's going to depend on what is the government decide to do as far as taking some risk again on how do we create protocol for accepting that customers coming from a different environment. I mean, the way it is right now, we have been very successful in protecting the island and the population. That's wonderful. But obviously, we know the rest of the world is not at the same level. And it will be like that for a long time. So it's going to depend, obviously, on technology, on testing, but also on a willingness and a focus to be able to make it happen, accepting certain risk when we move in that direction.
So do you think that the high net worth sector is the target market to go for first, which I guess positions an establishment like the Ritz-Carlton as somewhere that could attract customers?
Well, it's not just the Ritz-Carlton. We have, overall, as an island, an environment that is going to attract a certain level of the society because of the sense of safety, well-being, and safety that is even more enhanced. I mean, that was making our success before the crisis, and now it's even more evident. I think we got to be careful not to be so judgmental, says, oh, we're only going to get the rich people. It's not that. I think it's more about being able to test on a small population and figure out what does it look like. Just the same way we do right now with opening sector by sector. How do we select it? It's not necessarily fair for everybody, but it's what is the most logical way to bring back business.
Right. You don't start with a 6,000 cruise ship. You start with a,
correct.
Like you said, a six-person
Yes.
private jet. Marc, you're always an optimist. How optimistic do you feel right now about the future of the hotel and the future of tourism in the Cayman Islands?
Wow, tough question. Yes, optimistic because that's the only way that I know how to deal with life. Continuously have been challenged and finding solution, always being proactive. But season one is going to be it's an optimism but a reserve at the same time because the environment is not going to be back to where it was soon enough. I am usually very impatient. I like to make progress very fast, and I can see that no matter what we do, it's going to take a long path to get where we want to be.